Well, hello and welcome to Create Talks.
Hi.
I have Christopher Sims here with me.
Finally.
I'm so excited. You have no idea who you have before you right now. You are going to be blown away. Christopher was my intern and just now a real comrade in what the Holy Spirit's been doing around the planet. I know that we'll always be connected. But Christopher, you have so many things to share. It's crazy. First of all, I want you to share your journey of how you've grown in encounters with God, and why are encounters so important if we are to learn to reach out and be creative in our destiny. I teach an encounters class in our second year program, and Christopher, every week I would see him come with these, like, oh yeah, and then this happened, and then God showed up, and we were just talking about an encounter he had.
Yeah.
But encounters are so huge when we pair them up with our creativity and destiny, but share.
You know, I've grown in encounters a lot this year, and I noticed that the real shift happened when I read your book, Born to Create.
Oh,
my
wow.
Dreams just became a platform for God to encounter me and show me what he wanted to do in the world, and
oh, wow.
Even with my destiny. I saw all sorts of amazing things and with fashion and instruments, but I actually looked up the word encounter. And there, you know, there's a verb and there's a noun.
Yeah.
A noun. And the noun is a casual or unexpected meeting with someone or something.
Right.
And so the reason why that's so important is because when we encounter God, whether it's casually or unexpected, usually God uses that to show us what he wants for our lives.
Oh,
he usually
yeah.
uses encounters to not even do that, but to change our name, like with Jacob.
Exactly.
Who I was reading about yesterday. It's so important. Because when God gives you a name, then you know what direction you're going in. He shows
so
you your destiny.
Yeah. And it's so cool, too, I think, Christopher, too, because in this whole thing about what we're learning about encounters, it's like having a God encounter changed everything for Peter. It changed everything for what you talked about, Jacob, mm-hmm. and for Abraham. And it actually changed. Their names were changed.
That's the truth.
It's just crazy. So you started on this journey,
mm-hmm.
and then you began to discover more and more about who you are through creativity, and
yes.
then you did this thing called the 40-day challenge.
Yes, I did. I did finish that.
Oh my gosh, so in my group, we always do a 40-day challenge in my creative family, and
yes.
share about what you learned about yourself through that. And
oh my goodness.
What God did.
You know, with the 40-day challenge, I learned how important it is to be consistent with something.
Come on.
You know, the first time I was supposed to do the 40-day challenge, I had to admit and confess to Teresa that I did not finish it. You know, because things got in the way. Excuses, reasons, right? I just, oh, well, I'm tired today. Okay, I'll do two tomorrow. And in
Come on,
the end,
none of us have ever done that before, right?
Okay, thank you.
Let's
yeah,
laugh at that.
That's, yeah, you know, and so I procrastinated. I had to own up and clean up my mess. When I actually did complete the 40-day challenge, I realized what I gained was a sense of, it's sort of like resilience. You have to push through a wall. You know, when you're supposed to do something and you're like, well, I don't
yeah.
feel like it, it just built sort of this grit and this strength inside of me. But also, the creative juices, if you will, started flowing. So
Come
my
on.
40-day challenge, we could all create our own. And mine was to do a prophetic art piece every single day for 40 days.
Hello, that's a lot.
Yes, that is a lot. And so that requires having communion with the Lord in creating and having him lead you in creativity.
Yeah.
And so the reason why I was so happy with that is because when I ran out of energy, when I didn't want to create anymore, I had to fully rely on the Holy Spirit, which I should have been doing in the first place. But through that, I learned how to hear his voice even more. And I learned how he speaks even more, even through things like colored pencils. It's really cool.
It's crazy. And I really want to encourage you out there, like, this is alive, so if you have any questions for Christopher about his 40-day challenge, about what's happening in his life, about what he's learned as a seer in encounters, we really want to hear from you and where you're from and what God's doing. One of the things that I know happened too, that in this process, you grew in developing a place where you trusted in the Holy Spirit.
That's the truth.
And there
yes.
were so many testimonies that came from that.
Oh, yes.
It's just crazy. And then you began to do Create 28. So Create 28, if you don't know about it, it's on my Create Academy. And on my online courses, and this is great because it's 28 sessions to unlock your creativity.
That's true.
And then there's also a Facebook community where you can grow from and join as you purchase that. But so you began this journey,
yes,
and you got to share some testimonies because this is going to blow you away.
Share testimonies of Create 28.
Oh my gosh, goodness.
Share so many testimonies. But well, first of all, I have to say that as well, I did not finish the first time. And I had to, you know, I had to own up to that, and I had to apologize. And I'm not saying it's right, but it's so important to repent. And just to be restored, yeah, and to not give up, you know, that's just something that I've had to learn. It's so important. So Create 28, you know, I'm really glad I did the 40-day challenge because it started teaching me even more how to depend on the voice of the Holy Spirit. And then when I got into Create 28, I noticed that I had been kind of coasting at the beginning. I was doing what I knew was right. But I think it was towards the end, I realized I can really just flow with the Holy Spirit. I can flow with the Holy Spirit in the things that I create. And he challenged me. The thing that I love about Create 28 is you get as much as you put in. And so there's one part that says, hey, do something that challenges you. What's something that challenges you? And I thought, well, I'll just do a little prophetic picture for one of my neighbors.
Wow.
But that's not really a challenge. And I felt like the Lord kind of poked me on that. And so I realized, oh, I think I'm supposed to do a prophetic picture for this manager at this huge local coffee business.
Come on.
And I did, and it was accepted really, really well. I see that someone commented named Simon. I hope it's...
No, it's Simone from Switzerland.
Sorry.
We're so glad I was with you. This is crazy. Simone is commenting about you, Christopher.
Hi, Simone.
And says that you were so powerful, encouraging, and helpful.
Oh, thank you.
Oh my gosh, you guys, one of the things that I love about what Christopher just did is like he comments, and so I have interns and people that comment about how you're growing and what God's doing. And so I just want to encourage you to look at that, and you can grow on your creativity by doing this.
You can.
Also, a shout out to Orange County. Woo! Yeah,
yes.
Come on. You're my family. Georgia, Switzerland, Baton Rouge, and Lebanon.
Yes.
Woo! We're so glad that you've joined us. My gosh, it's so awesome.
Can I put a little plug in there?
Yeah.
At the beginning, you mentioned the word seer. I don't
yes.
know if everybody knows what that is, but some of you watching are actually seers, and
yeah.
you're going to begin to see things like colors. If you're seeing flashes of colors, or,
yes.
You know, I feel like God is starting to teach some of you the ways that he talks differently, not just through your spirit, but he's going to start talking to you through environment. So just pay attention to what God's doing around you. I just wanted to put that in there.
I agree with you. And it's crazy how much when you follow the Holy Spirit, and you use creativity, things just shift and change. Like,
yes.
we were just together at the School of Creativity.
Yes.
And, oh my gosh, I cannot tell you how many testimonies I'm reading about what happened that are related to Christopher
oh
as well.
Oh my goodness.
About singing, about blessing people. But it's great because in the School of Creativity, we don't just have speakers come, and we just don't have like 40 different workshops that you can choose from in all different kinds of creative ways, but we also have creative booths.
That's the truth. Yeah.
And these creative booths are in art mm-hmm. and in music and in dance and in fashion.
And in culinary.
All these different kinds of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And it's during the break time, so people can come and they can receive. And you were leading one of the big teams out in
our
breezeway area.
Yes, it was.
And share some testimonies about what happened out there.
Ooh, oh my
it's
goodness.
Crazy.
There's a lot of, there's one testimony that really touched my heart so dearly. A lot of people were touched, but there was this one testimony in particular where I actually ended up singing over somebody.
Yeah.
I ended up saying, is that okay if I share that?
Oh, please do. Yeah, they gave permission.
They
yeah.
gave permission.
Yeah.
Okay, that's amazing. You know, it was actually after one of our Q&A sessions.
Yep, I have that.
And someone came up, you know, after everyone had finished asking questions, and this lady asked if, you know, she was going to ask me a question, but I felt like I was supposed to give her a prophetic word. And what she didn't tell me was that it was a desire of her heart to have someone give her a specific prophetic word. And I said, you know what? I think I'm going to sing a prophetic song over you, actually. And she goes, oh, that would be even better. And so I sing this song. I barely had a voice because we just go.
Oh, my gosh. It's
oh,
so
we
true.
Just go. I'm still recovering. We just go
oh
at
my gosh.
School Creativity.
You have no idea how my team puts on a full with like over 1,000 people. Like, this is crazy what this team does.
Yes, Korea 28 and 40 Day Challenge was preparation for this.
I totally
being
was.
Strengthened by the Lord, because we just, we're talking. And so I sang over her this song, "You Are My Sunshine." And when I sang that over her, she just broke. And I didn't know the power, and I didn't have much of a voice. So that just goes to some of you,
totally.
Just to let you know. And oh, this is another thing about the platform of Create 28 and the mm-hmm. online course that you have going on. What I love was that so many people who are artistic, or maybe they're not the best at art or whatever, so many of these people are being encouraged and flowing in creativity.
It's
you know,
true.
You don't have to be Michelangelo or Picasso. And that's what I learned, because my voice wasn't at the best, but I partnered with the Lord and I sang of this lady, even though my voice was cracking. And she completely broke. And the song that the Lord told me to sing over her was the song that she actually used to sing over one of her children that was a foster child, and he actually got taken away from her. And so God was actually healing that. We were able to pray over her and minister to her in that moment.
You know, you have no idea the power of your creativity that can transform the people around you. You have no idea how he is going to lead you.
That's true. Yeah.
Simone has a question for you, Christopher.
When
did you start painting with God?
That's a great question. Actually, I started painting with God when I was 19.
Wow.
I was 19 years old, and I remember, wow, that's so awesome. Yeah, oh yes, that's so good. There's so many good things. I'm like, I need to get all of it at once. I was 19, I was living in Juneau, Alaska, and I would buy these huge slabs of plywood from Home Depot, and I would get them cut in half, and I would just paint with acrylic over the plywood.
Wow.
And I noticed that sometimes when the paint should have went outside of the lines, it just wouldn't. And I'm wondering, why is it going exactly where it needs to go? And sometimes I would be painting, and all of a sudden I would just start speaking in tongues, and I didn't know what was going on.
Come on.
And I realized that God was partnering with me through painting, so I was about 19 years old.
And it's crazy, because it's like, I have a shout out. I know Christopher would love this. I feel like there's many of you that are like Christopher. You just haven't discovered your creative voice, whether it's in art or music or dance or fashion or whatever. And God's right now, he's saying all you have to do is partner with his presence, and things just are going to shift and change. It's just crazy. Oh, we have some other comments here too. Zara.
Oh, yes.
And then I've seen colors and visions and just painted my first color painting yesterday.
Yes.
Woo, celebrate you.
Yes.
We're so excited.
Really. And whenever you see those colors, I encourage you, Zara, ask the Lord what those colors mean. I believe he might start showing you colors over people. You'll be looking at someone, you might see a blue light over somebody or a red light. Ask the Lord, what are you saying through this?
That's right.
And then go to the person and ask for confirmation. Does this mean anything to you? Yes. Okay.
Is Becky, and she's asking, can you speak on creativity, healing,
racial division?
Oh my gosh. If you want to know about racial division and the healing, you've got to get the School of Creativity.
Yes.
You have to, because that was the thread was throughout the whole entire time in a lot of our artists in the dramatic spoken word and in singing actually completely opened up healing through that. It just was dynamic.
Yes, this year the School of Creativity set a new standard for sure. I believe both for the world and for the church. I believe because this year the creativity was very supernatural.
Yeah.
And it ministered to issues that are so important today, but it did it in such a loving way, in such an eye-opening way. And the arts were just excellent. So if you want to know about racial reconciliation and stopping the division, I would definitely say get that of the School of Creativity. But when it comes to creative healing, I mean, we have so many. You know, what I love about Theresa Dedman is she does this thing. She calls it stepping over the chicken line.
I do.
And she plays chicken really well.
Yeah,
and
it's
I remember
so true.
We were in it seemed like a healing school. Is that Twinview? Remember we were recording all the healings?
Oh, yes. Oh, my gosh. Yes, that's right.
Well, she had her team. I'm a part of that team. She said, I want you to ask Lord today to highlight a body part that needs to be healed for someone later on in the day during our school, during this healing session. And the Lord told me an elbow. And so later that day, she calls me up and says, okay, Christopher, what did the Lord tell you this morning? And I said, is there someone here who needs healing for their elbow? And there was one person in this huge room.
It's crazy.
But this is what Theresa did. She really set up the game of chicken well. She said, wait a minute. Everyone, is that okay that she has pain in her elbow? And everyone goes, no. And she goes, all right, do you want to see her get totally healed? And everyone goes, yeah. And she goes, well, where's your pain? And the lady said it was an 8 out of 10. I'm like, good Lord.
That was bad.
Yeah, I'm like, oh my goodness. And she goes, well, Christopher is going to sing over you right now, and God is going to completely heal you. Okay, Christopher, go.
Yeah, we call that crossing over. If you're not familiar with that term, because in America we say, if you want to face whatever fear, you would cross over the most thing that you're most afraid of. And then we call that the chicken line. So
yes.
This for Christopher, it's like, here he is. He's scared to death already. And then I say, well, you're going to sing and they're going to get healed. And he's going, oh, no pressure.
Yeah. I don't, you know what? I don't think I was even scared. But yeah. But I think I got nervous when you said, you're going to get completely healed. I was fine because I knew, okay, there's an elbow. But then she's like, you're going to get complete. I love her faith. You know what? When you have someone who has faith that pulls you outside of your boat and your comfort zone, that's what you need to be around people. And I pray that God would put some of you in communities that call you to a higher standard.
And that you would challenge yourself. And so this person got completely healed.
Yeah, so I sang over this woman, and I just, it was a simple line. I said, your elbow's healed right now. All the pain has to go down.
Yeah.
And she tested it out, and her eyes opened. I don't know if Peter can put the clip on there, because it's recorded.
Yeah.
It's amazing.
Yeah, she was completely healed.
Completely healed.
And she was shocked. Like, there was a look in her face like, what? God just really healed me?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, we have other people joining us from, I think,
the Bahamas,
mm-hmm.
UK.
UK, Norway, so many more. We're so glad you're here. Share this because we want you to get activated.
You know,
this is what it's all about. But share with us one truth that you'd like for everyone watching to hear about.
Oh, I'd love to do that.
Come on. You know what?
One truth is that everyone is born to create.
Yes.
Everyone is creative. You can create. You don't have to look like the person to your left or to your right. You know, in the beginning, God created. You are made in His image and His likeness, which means you are creative. You're made in the likeness of God. You're supposed to create. It's what you're born to do. And I don't want you to ever think that creativity has to be in a box.
Come on. You
don't have to be a painter or a singer or a dancer.
Yes.
You know what I mean? Creativity can look like administration.
Holy.
Creativity can look like photography. There's all sorts of things that are creative. So you are creative.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's what I
You know, one of the things I know, David, you asked a question about, you've done a couple prophetic paintings, but you feel like you have to be a perfectionist with your work. And so you'll kind of restart and doing it over. How do I let go and allow God? The first thing is to realize, like, God, it's kind of like this. It's like, if I understand that I'm an instrument and God is playing me. He's actually up, like, if the Holy Spirit's inside of me, I'm partnering with Him, and that creativity is meant to transform people. So the way that you're looking at it is like your painting, that has to be perfect, but it's the process of you being with the Holy Spirit as you create, and that He wants to show you how much that's going to touch somebody. I think Christopher can,
yes.
I'll have him share a testimony, but I have to tell you, some of the quickest paintings I've done are the ones I haven't really liked, have so ministered to people, it blows my mind. And why is that important? Because it's not about you getting everything right. It's about you trusting the Holy Spirit with what you create and allowing that to be given to someone. And that's when the miracle happens. Mm-hmm. I want you to study, by the way, about what Jesus did when He multiplied the loaves and the fishes, and how He thanked God for what He had,
yes.
and then He gave it away, and then He saw the miracle.
Yes.
So you need to see the miracle.
Yeah.
That it's not in being perfect, it's in you trusting the Holy Spirit to use what you've created to transform mm-hmm. people.
And David, I want to say thank you for asking such a vulnerable question, because there
yes.
are other people who probably have that question as well. I do want to say as well, one thing that I've learned, I grew up in a very... the environment when it comes to creativity, it's high performance, high excellence. What I mean by that is just performing to be loved
yes.
instead of from love.
Yes.
One thing that changed the game for me, David, was feeling the pleasure of the Lord. When I got alone in my bathroom, sat on the floor in the dark, and I sang to God, and I could feel His pleasure.
All of
a sudden, I realized, this is what I want. I have an audience of one. And when I led worship at a church, I just could see the Lord, and I would sing to Him. And it wasn't about what people were thinking about me. And so it's really important to ask God, can I feel your pleasure? Focus on the pleasure of the Lord. Just know or meditate on the scriptures that say how the Lord is pleased with you and how He loves you. And that's what's really going to let you let go. When you realize that you are pleasing to God and that He is pleased with whatever you create. Yeah.
I really think, and this is for everyone that's listening right now, I feel like you need to understand, like, there's a curious button that needs to go on in your head. If you create something with the presence of God, it's meant to touch someone. So, like, if I'm at the store, if I'm about doing stuff and whatever, and I think, oh my gosh, that song is for this person, or oh my gosh, there's something going on that this needs to be related to. When I look at my gift and what I've been created to be as a conduit to bless somebody else, then what happens is, like what he talks about, you've already found the pleasure of God in your secret place. That's and secret. Now it's time for you to see why you've been created.
I mean, yes.
I have a question to ask you. What if Jesus, the Father, and the Holy Spirit, they created the world without anyone seeing it? What if, the Michelangelo, the Sistine Chapel, all that happened, what if he created it and then he just painted black over it? No, he created it for a purpose, wow. For a reason. See, you've been created to show forth the glory of God. And your creativity is not about you trying to make God the creator. Yeah, it's good. But we're running out of time, so yes. Christopher, I want you to impart. You've shared so many incredible
yes.
truths.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I would love to impart over you right now to feel the pleasure of the Lord.
Yes.
I would like to impart, Lord, that you would breathe on everyone's creativity, that you would
yeah.
breathe on them. I say no to every bit of insecurity.
Yes.
I say, Lord, I thank you that they would just focus on your truth. And I just want to sing over you as well. I want to sing something. And I want to say, you are enough.
Wow.
You are enough. You are enough. And the Lord loves you. You are enough. And God loves you so much. He loves you so much.
Oh my gosh. I feel like, okay, this is just a prophetic word I have right now, being with Christopher.
That's fun.
I feel like there are people that you know right now that need to hear what just happened. And I feel like you know who they are. They need to hear there's something that's been on their life where they have never been free, or they've never crossed over the chicken line, or they've never seen the testimonies about what God can do through creativity. And I want to really ask you to be bold and share, to go after that, share from your own life victories, or share this with other people and share this link, because God really wants to touch people. This
mm-hmm.
is
he does.
It's so powerful. Like what we've experienced, I mean, I can't tell you just this year how many people Christopher has touched because he's taken a risk and he's crossed over the chicken line. it's been insane. So anyway, enjoy, share, and we'll see you next week. Goodbye.
Thank you so much.
Bye.